Dear friends, welcome to Learning About. In this video, we're going to see one of the latest recruitment notifications from our Indian Army. So this notification is for the recruitment of commissioned officers under the Short Service Commission technical entry for both men and women. The online application process has already started. It's going on from 25th May 2021 and the last date will be 23rd June 2021, 3 p.m. And as far as the posts are concerned, it is the commissioned officer post in the Indian Army under the Short Service Commission technical entry. And this is equivalent to the Group A post. So they are equal to the gazetted officer cadre, and the number of vacancies for the men it is 175, for the women it is 14, and the pay scale, the starting pay is pay level 10, it is 56,100 per month, and there are a lot of other benefits. The eligibility criteria: nationality should be an Indian. The age limit for both men and women, the candidate should be unmarried, okay, both at the time of application as well as at the time of the training, the candidate should be unmarried, and age between 20 to 27 as on 1st October 2021. So that means born between 2nd October 1994 to 1st of October 2001, both dates are inclusive. And there is another entry for, that's for the widows of defense personnel who died in harness. For them, there are only two vacancies actually. So one is a non-technical non-UPSC entry. Another one is a technical entry. For both of that, the maximum age limit is 35 years of age as on 1st October 2021. So the educational qualification is concerned. The candidate should have passed engineering degree, or if you are in the final year also, you can have the, if the candidates are in the final year, they can also apply, but at the time of application there should not be any standing arrears. So this is the vacancy stream wise. Okay, so total of 175 vacancies for the men. So civil department or civil stream, it is 60 vacancies, and computer science 31 vacancies, IT 12 vacancies, and so on. And please remember, as far as computer science IT is concerned, even MSc computer science, MSc IT candidates can also apply. For the women, there are 14 vacancies. Now, wherever required, please pause the video to look at the details. So this is for the men and this is for the women. So as far as the type of commission is concerned, so the candidates who are finally shortlisted after the interview will be on a probation in the rank of lieutenant, right from the commencement of training, and the training will happen in the officers training academy in Chennai in Tamil Nadu. And right from the time of training, the trainees are entitled for the full pay and allowances. However, the pay and allowances will be paid only after the successful completion of the training. And after the successful completion of the training, the officer will be confirmed, you know, like the Short Service Commission technical in the rank of lieutenant. So training, that's for a duration of the candidates who finally get selected after the service selection board interview and the medical fitness. So, and who come in the top, they as per the vacancies and eligibility and all that. So once they complete the interview and the medical fitness, so they'll be called for the training. As I said, that will happen in the OTA Chennai, and the duration of the training is 49 weeks. So after the successful completion of training, they'll be commissioned. So as far as the tenure of engagement with the Indian Army is concerned, the officers, both male and female, they can serve for 10 years. At the end of 10 years, they can seek an extension of 4 years. right? Now, according to their eligibility and like suitability, and then the vacancies, the services may be extended for 4 years, or in many cases, the officers, you know, like who are desirous of seeking a permanent commission, they may be considered for a permanent commission, again, with accordance to their eligibility and suitability, and according to the vacancies. So, which means they can, if they get the permanent commission, they can, after 10 years, if they get the permanent commission, they can go on to serve the Indian Army until the age of their retirement. So, this is the promotion criteria. Here again, you can pause the video and look at the details. And this is the pay. Right. So, as I said, at the entry level, the pay is 5600, but apart from the pay, you get a lot of benefits, okay, like the accommodation, you know, like medical facilities, medical insurance, and then the leave travel allowance, okay, and now allowance for children's education and so on. So, it comes with a lot of benefits. And of course, it's one of the prestigious professions in the country. So, as far as the selection procedure is concerned, based on the CGPA, grade, percentage, the candidates are called for the Services Selection Board interview, the SSB interview. Okay, so first shortlisting of applications, and then the candidates will be allotted the different centers for the SSB interview. Okay, there are 4 centers, one in Allahabad, Uttar Pradesh, Bhopal, Madhya Pradesh, Bengaluru in the state of Karnataka, and Kapurthala in the state of Punjab. Right. So, and then there'll be the SSB interview, and SSB interview, it happens in 2 stages. The stage 1 will happen on day 1. It will be a screening test. The candidates attempt an intelligence test. Okay. That is verbal and non-verbal, and a picture perception test. And people who qualify stage 1, only those candidates will be called for stage 2. In stage 2, that will be on day 2. You'll have a psychology test, thematic appreciation test, okay, picture story writing, word association test, situation reaction test, and a self description test. That will be on day 2. And on day 3 and 4, the group testing officers, okay, so they will be giving tasks such as group discussion, group planning exercise, progressive group tasks, okay. So, individual obstacles will be there, group obstacles will be there, okay. There'll be different races, command tasks, okay, and then a final group task. So, all that will be happening in day 3 and 4. And then on the final day, on day 5, there'll be a discussion between the candidate and the board of officers. That is more like a personal interview. And then finally, the result will be announced, and the candidates who are selected will be sent for the medical examination. And medical, as far as the medical examination requirement is concerned, it is same as any other officer recruitment in the Indian Army. Okay, so same conditions are there. So if you want to know more about those medical conditions, you can look in the Indian Army website, the link to which is given in the description below. So it is the selection is purely based on the merit. So people who have, you know, like higher CGPA will be called for the Services Selection Board interview, and who come in the top in the interview and who are medically fit will be finally called for the training at the OTH. How to apply? So the link is given in the description below. You can click on that link, wherein you will find you'll go into the page joinindianarmy.nic.in. So you'll find a link for the officer entry application login. You click on that. First, you will you have to register. In that registration, the instruction will be in both English and Hindi. So you have to enter your Aadhaar number or the enrollment number. Then your name, father's name, mother's name, date of birth, email address, and mobile number. And then you will receive a OTP in mobile. Right, and you may be asked for the gender, marital station, status, and the security question. So all these details will be asked. Now, once you complete the registration, then you have to apply for this particular course, wherein you have to, you know, like upload your photograph, your signature, and then you have to give your educational details and all that. And finally, you can submit the application. And after you complete the process, if you are called for the, after scrutiny of your application, if you are called for the services selection board interview, you should carry printout. Okay, so that should be self-attested. You should carry the printout of the application. Along with that, you should have your 10th mark sheet, 12th mark sheet, then your engineering degree certificate or the provisional degree certificate, engineering degree certificate or the provisional certificate. Also, you should have the mark sheets of all the semesters or all the years. Right. Now, let's say if you are in the final year, then you should get a letter. You should get a certificate from your college acknowledging that, okay, you are in the final year, and whatever certificates given up to that point of time that you should have, then you should get a certificate from the college saying that, okay, so you are pursuing the final year and all that. So that that letter is mandatory for you to be considered. Okay. Now, apart from all this, now, since, you know, like as far as the CGPA is concerned, different universities follow different type of, you know, like grading. So that equivalence of CGPA grade to percentage. Okay. So different universities follow different norms. Now, that equivalence you should obtain from your controller of examination or from the registrar's office of the concerned, you know, like university or the institution, you should get it. Now, that also you should carry it when you go for the services selection board interview. So I hope the information I have given in this video was useful to you. Now, if you have any questions, any doubts, please post your questions and doubts in the comment section below. For more videos on job alerts, aptitude, reasoning, and general awareness, please like, share, and subscribe to our channel Learning About. Thanks for watching the video. Have a great day.